dangerous in the forest. Boo. That's right, it's me, Scryptar. How you doing, folks? Welcome back to another episode of ARK Primitive Shigo Plus. And yes, it's awfully dark, although we have torches going for us. Let's come up a little. Hi. You see me now? Ooh. All right. I still like how the mushroom is glowing. That's just beautiful. Anyway, I finished part of the greenhouse. I put in all the roofs. I put in all the crop plots. I put in all, you know, the structures underneath. The water taps are there. It just rained, so we should have some water in here. Did have some water in here. I don't know. Still have to see if everything works as it should, but I think that's not a big problem here. We might extend that a little bit, you know, exchange that pipe that's going out there into an intersection so we can place one more to the left and one more to the right and have like three of these stone reservoirs on each veg. We need cementing paste for that, so we're gonna hold off on that one until I get to raid the next beaver dam. Over here is the bridge going out to that mushroom, and yes, we do have a little issue with this ping today, so you might see some rubber bending. That's exactly what I meant. It's lighting up nicely. It's looking really, really cute. Move the resource crop stuff over here. There's the magical structure bench, and there's the seed bench. We have seed storage in that storage box. That's the word, over there. And I finished this one wall. How did I do that? Well, you can see it up here. I put up the veggies, the slope walls, and then just built down from there, as we don't have any snap points down here. But we have snap points on those veggies, which is quite nice. Left a gap here, 4 high, 2 wide, for a metal gate with a glass door. This is awfully loud, but I'm gonna do it again. This is auto opening and closing. You just have to get close, I'm not pressing anything. It has a weird double sound effect, you know, it plays the sound file twice. That was a good demonstration, I think. But then again, it opens automatically. You don't have to do anything. It's sometimes a little wonky which direction it opens. I think if you sneak in from the side here, sometimes it opens outside, then it opens inside, then it doesn't open at all. Usually it works, just not when the ping is too bad, or when you come in with two people, one standing outside, the other one trying to move, then it gets confused which one to follow and if it should open or close. So you run into the glass wall sometimes. That's fine. It's glass. The structure is not really primitive looking, but then again, we do need the greenhouse effect to get stuff going, and we only have 300%. See, I planted these yesterday as soon as I could. These two wedges were already done. So that's been growing for like 12 hours, and this is all we get. I mean, that is enough if once or twice a day you want to put up another seed. Well, you need your 40 mushrooms and 40 flowers and a little magical essence, whatever that might be. That's why essence in this case. It's definitely not enough if you want to get like 5,000 crystal to do 40 greenhouse walls or something. So we will probably exchange these to at least 2 Essen. They're still wood-looking crop plots, so we might even go as high as 5 Essen. We do not want to have too many resources, otherwise we do not need our dinosaurs to get out and get some resources. And you know, we want to have basically half of it covered, so we can do some stuff. So I could jump in here and say, okay, today we're going to build another greenhouse, so I need 60 walls, and I'm able to do 30 of them, so I can show you some stuff, and then I can go off-cam and farm a little bit and do the rest and, you know, get you guys back in when it's done. That's fine enough for me. Don't want to come in here and have everything laid out for me, otherwise we are never going to leave this area because everything is here. It was good for the last season, because we were more out for taming all the Anunnaki creatures. This season we want to do more environmental things, you know, going out on Allosaurus and, you know, hunt around a little, stuff like that. Alright, so I'm going to do most of this off-cam. I might bring you in whenever I have a new seed ready to craft or ready to plant, or plant it so you can see it growing, something like that, so you see this greenhouse coming together and being nice and shiny and all of that. Alright, also, we do want to put a little logic behind the stuff we are doing. This is a wooden platform, right? And if you put earth and water and fertilizer and all of that on a wooden platform, it starts to rot. So that's why you put these stone slabs, stone ceiling of course, on there and the plot on that. So this is not going to go all moldy on us and rot away and break apart. You know, it does make some sense. I mean, we're pretty proud of what we're doing here in terms of logic. All right, I still have to finish all of this. I didn't put in these walls here because I ran out of materials. And I think we have like 300 crystal left or something like that. So it will take some time. Put up torches all around so we get good light. Let me gamma down again. Should be what we have. 6 a.m. Well, it's fine. I mean, looks good. Need more light. I mean, you see the light radius here that from those torches goes up until here. And from these is like up until here. There is a huge darkness patch. I have to see if we find some path lights so that we can have a path around there. We might even put down, you know, a real path on this like we did with the stone ceilings over here. See if we can curve something along. ARK doesn't really provide us with the tools to do so without making it look wonky, so we'll have to check if that's a thing. Unfortunately, the platforms mod doesn't come with triangle-shaped extensions that we could just put next to a perfectly placed ceiling to cover this area. That would be really, really nice. Alright, enough rambling about what mods don't do. Let's go. Over here, nothing much changed. Well, I took those two crafting stations away, obviously. Once we have all of these crafting benches and forges and storage and kitchen stuff moved to different platforms, yeah, there's gonna be more, like that tree, that mushroom over there, and we have a mushroom coming up over there, and there's still that big one over there, and there's trees in between, like from that platform over there, we might want to go to that tree to connect to that mushroom. We might then also want to go to that one and even have a connection from here going there, so that we have all of this interconnected. Might even do that one because it's close. Don't know yet. We still need one more platform for our land creatures, like the small ones. Dodic, if you can call an Allosaurus small, I don't know, but they are going to go on those platforms. Might even do two platforms, one on top of the other, and have a spiral walkway on top or something. We're going to try those. And then we're going to decorate this whole lake. So this up here will be our main chillout area when everything on this platform is removed. We already have the pub bar top counter thing. There's going to be stools, and there's going to be tables, and there's going to be a keg, and maybe a working beer barrel and all of that. And then we're going to decorate this into our little arboretum. You know, using all of the stuff that's in here. There's trees and bushes. Bushes and crystals and dead trees and living trees and mossy stuff and mushrooms and big mushrooms and small mushrooms and pumpkins. There's so much stuff in here, even these. They don't seem to give much light, but they look cool. We don't really need light under here, as these spots are giving light quite nicely in the night. And you want to have it a little dark so you get the feeling of what we put in here. And maybe have, you know, a curved snake-like path around the whole thing, or we just use the inside here as the path, and then we have our little patches. Each veg could hold a different kind of biome or something like that. That's what we're going to try out. This platform is going to be chill out to the max. Later. First, we need to remove all this stuff. So today, I'm not 100% sure what we're going to work on. I think we do need to start putting up walls around this area. I'm going to use stone gates for that, as usual. Far enough away so that creatures outside don't aggro on our creatures inside. So we can leave them all in passive and nobody starts attacking our walls. Close enough so that when you're standing on these platforms you can look over the gates and don't have to look at the gates and miss all the lovely scenery. So when I'm standing here, like, I would have the gate, the top of the gate, right through this railing. So when I'm standing here and I look exactly at this point, and the railing wasn't there, I would look at the top of the gate. So all the area down there would be covered by the gate, and all the area behind that would just look foresty, as it should. Have to see if that works. There are some structures in here that I would like to try. There is a different kind of fence that snaps to foundations and everything that makes sure that fences are all the same height. You know, when you place a fence foundation and you place the next one and the ground is a little uneven, that fence foundation places lower or higher. These fences don't. So the top is always the same height. That might be nice to try. Don't know if that's going to work for us because this is pretty uneven here. I mean, there's a hill over there, and there's a valley over there, and then you have the pond. We're going to see. And we're back at the greenhouse. I decided it's a good time to get this started. I mean, the essentials are there. We have a roof, we have greenhouse effect, we have water. Irrigation is Everything is there, so why not get started just now? I mean, we need the stuff anyway. I've put up some signs, because I needed to make sure that we figure out what to put where. You know, it should make sense, and we only have so many crop plots. Can't really put up more without breaking this whole nice layout. So we're gonna skip a few things, like, you know, the Ein Essen. Why would you want that if one tail swipe of the Bronto gives you like 100 seeds and 1,000 Ein Essen, magical Essen, whatever. So we're gonna do 2 Essen, 3 Essen, 4 Essen, 5 Essen, as it says right here. That should be fine. That's all we need. The rest we can get just, you know, snip your fingers. Flowers, shrooms, dyes, and skins. I didn't really know where to put dyes and skins, and I do want to have both. Making dyes just takes time, and, you know, it's easier to put them just here. We do want to have the skins, so why not put them here as well? There's nothing really logical you can put here. These are ingredients you only really need. Well, some of them you need for the mods, like bridges and stuff, like mushrooms for whatever reason, but usually you only need those to craft seeds. So we want to have these and those close together, and that's what I did here. And then, of course, if you go through here, wood, thatch, fiber kind of belongs together. Gel, I couldn't put anywhere else, so I put it here because I had the slot free. Then we have stone, flint, obsidian, metal. That all comes from rocks. You know, it makes sense somehow. So, want to get this started. Prepared a little stuff here. Start at the very bottom. Got some ingredients in here. Already got some seeds crafted, which we need in a second. We do want to have flint. It's easy to craft. Let's do that. We do want to have hide, which needs meat seeds. I already have 3 meat seeds made up. We're not going to plant meats. Meats? Meat seeds. What would we do that for? I mean, every time we go out, we definitely kill stuff and we get meat. And we don't need it for taming. For that, we get kibble. So why would you ever want to plant that? It's one of the things that you can leave out if you don't have the space, which we don't have. So then thatch. Yes, of course, we do want thatch. We do want fiber. We do want stone, and we do want wood, right? So that's all made up. Don't need that. Thanks. So, we have thatch, flint, hide, fiber, stone, and wood. That's a good start. To get further, for crystal you need stone seeds. For obsidian you need stone seeds. For metal you need stone seeds. And fears, which we don't have yet. It costs a hell of a lot of effort to do those when you just start with Ines. So that's what we're going to do as soon as the stone crop lot yields some seeds. So we don't have to do this all over again. You know, makes sense. We do have some time. And it is fairly easy to get still. Just, you know, you want to have your stockpile, which we're going to get. So almost 300 health. Cool. Saved me from dying earlier, which is good. So, don't have anything for you. Do have something for you. Wood. Fertilized everything. We do have more than enough dinosaurs to make magic fertilizer over at Plimichev's base. That magic compost bin was full, so I just took that. Thatch. Fiber. We should have thatch. And we should have fiber. Now, where did I put that? Right there? Yes. So that would be gel. Then a stone goes right in here. I want to have these close together because they are the main building resources, so it makes sense to have them close together, right? Flint we do have. And then it's just hide. And that's here, together with pelt and chitin, because that all comes from anywhere to kill. Same as the woody rhino horns. And then you have all the other, you know, megalodon teeth and that stuff right here. So even that is close together. Perfect. So this can get started and can get growing and yield us some seeds. And when all of that is done, we can use these seeds to get the higher resources. First thing I want to do, of course, is get enough of these. I think we need 1,000. No, actually, I think we need the next tier, right? That's those. Yeah, we need 100 of the next tier, so 100 magical Dreiessen. And if we look this up, Dreiessen needs 16 Zweiessen. So if we need 100, we need 1,600 magical Zweiessen to make 100 Dreiessen. And then it's just plant species X, flowers, mushrooms. We have that, as you can see, more than enough. We do need to get some more plant species X very soon, but it's not that much. of a difficulty right here. You know, it's one trip to the swamp. Also not gonna plant those. I don't know if it's just me or if it just doesn't work. I know you can put them in a tech crop plot, the magical plant species X seed. That. And it should grow seeds, but if you put them in a standard crop plot, it doesn't do anything. Exec consume fertilizer, it doesn't do anything. So we're not going to do that. We only need those to craft these magical seeds, and once we've arrived here, and even that only needs 10, I think. Yeah, and we have 38, so I guess 1, 2, 3, 30. That's all we need, so we actually don't need to go anywhere and do nothing. Unless you want to plant some of those, which we might do. You know, the regular plant X turrets. Oh no. Ran out of food. Need food. That should be fine. Each of them should give 50. I have 250, so four of them so should fill it up rather nicely. So, now we need to get back. I have started, and I emphasize started, the war. Now, I'm currently not using gates. I'm using structures plus again, just because I can, and because I wanted to try this. Ever since ARK introduced fence foundations, I was annoyed by the fact that you couldn't place one fence foundation next to another on uneven ground and have the walls the same height. Now look at all of this. This is the answer. Right here. It looks a little bit weird. Looks like, I don't know, a goal. not only does it show you where the wall is going to face, the outside, but it also gives you those two balls, the snap points. Well, that's really, ah, believe me, you can just place the first one, like, right here, and then you take a second one, and that snaps at that snap point, so it will be the same height, and after a lot of wiggling around, I need more of them anyway, so let's craft some, you can face, well, E changes direction, as usual, and you can face them wherever you like, in 45 degree angles, as you can see. It doesn't always work perfectly, especially when there's a height difference involved. So let's pick these up. Let me show you where I actually left off building. Or we can continue over here. You don't need to put them all the way up. As you can see, the walls here, there is nothing there. Well, it's walls stuck on walls, so that works fine. I guess if you have them, if the wall breaks, then the rest still has support. But then it's wood, right? I don't even know. Do we have them? Do we have those in not wood? What are they called? Fence support. Well, let's just look for fence. Not fabs. Fence. There's stone. We might swap that over to stone. Just for the support. And then do the walls in wood again. Maybe even the first two layers in stone and the rest in wood. I don't know, this is, at the moment, it's just for getting things started. So I started over here with, I think, that one, and then I built out that way. This was too deep in the ground. Well, for this one it worked, but this was too deep in the ground to snap another one next to it, so I stuck one on top, and then snuck that one in there. I can't, as you can see, if I go down here, I can't stick anything underneath. I can put one on top, don't have to, so why would I? Let's put this down. And this is exactly what I mean, it gets rather tedious to find the sweet spot. Again, if you put your crosshair out, crosshair? Don't crosshair, that's impolite. If you put your crosshair out, you might be able to do this easier, but there are just these situations where it wouldn't work. There you go. And then just hope that you don't wiggle your mouse too much and it places somewhere else. That's, well, you know, building an ARK has always been like this. Doesn't change. For the mods. Mods themselves, they are great, definitely. It's just, they have to use the standard ARK mechanics, and those are the ones that are wonky. So over here, for example, I get only a couple of directions it wants to face. I get that, and that, but I don't get the one in between. So, I want to go straight over there. That works perfectly for me. What I usually tend to do then is I pick the next best one, don't move the mouse, get the another one out, change direction, there you go, This is not really touching. I have to put one underneath, otherwise it will break once I remove this one. And now I can remove this one. And it's still broke. That happens. Yeah, it definitely does happen. Going down doesn't seem to be the way it wants to go. Oh, I had it there, right for a millisecond. I'll try to find that sweet spot again. It's even worse when you know it's there. There you go. That is the right, yeah, that is facing the right direction. It's getting dark again. So, let me continue doing this a while. You can snap a wall wherever you like here. You know, we could leave the bottom free and just have walls on top. Allow the Dillos in, but not the Rexes. I don't know, that might be something. No, I'm not gonna do that. It's getting dark, so I'm gonna continue doing this. You don't really need to watch this, you've seen that, you know how tedious it is, and you know that I will be standing here for about the next 800 hours, and then I will do a small portion of it and see what it looks like, and I might exchange some into stone and see what that looks like, and then I meet you right back. I think I'm gonna go with stone wall combination. Yeah, definitely. I mean, that was planned before, but I'm definitely gonna do it. Two stone walls at the bottom, two wooden walls on top. That's four high. That should be more than enough to keep everything out. It looks gorgeous. Let's have a look here. I'm fresh out of supplies, as you might see from the state of my hotbar. So why not just now? And yeah, that's coming along. Whenever we have to dip down, then I just put a wedge on top instead of the fourth wall. Works for me. Otherwise, it would get too high. Put a Structures Plus Behemoth Gate in here, and I think I turned that the wrong way around. I guess I could pick it up and replace it. We'll see. There's a little bit of a gap there. I guess that's not really noticeable. We might just put some decoration in front of that. But it looks good. It's a big wall. And it's coming along. And we haven't really done much in terms of getting a long way to finishing this. This took a lot of resources. I don't know. 7,500 stone? Maybe 12,000 wood? It's easy to get around here. That's not the issue. I mean, a tree like that, 1,000 wood right there. So, not much of a big deal. I like it. I really do like it. Let's see what that looks like from above. Could you please open? Thank you. Ah! Jay! I don't know. Now you're open. Or is that just a graphical glitch? That's better. Nope. So I really have to wait until you're fully open before I can walk through. It seems like it. Well, there you go. That's what it looks like from the inside. I used the stone fences support things all the way around. That works quite nicely. I haven't replaced those over there where we already started. I don't even know if you can replace those. It doesn't look like it. You would have to pick the old ones up and then place new ones. I'm a little bit scared that everything comes crashing down, and it's only that area over there, so I'm just not gonna bother. We need to get back up there and have a look. Ah, expert skills. Been doing this quite often. I need a primitive elevator. Still do. So, let's get over here. That should be good. Someday, one day, maybe, it might arrive. That's not too bad. Where's my bird? Down there? Yep. Okay, jump in the water, get the scout, come back up. I mean, that's the test wall there, four high, and I thought, nah, that's way too big, you don't really see it much. But then when I look at that, especially with the breakup in stone and wood, the wood doesn't, you know, scream you in the face like it does over there. Like, there's a structure here. There is stony ground, and then you have the wood all around with the redwoods. That looks like it blends in. Sort of. I mean, the wedges on top definitely do the trick. Unfortunately, there's no half stone, half wood wall, so we could have like the veg where we transition from stone to wood, you know what I mean? And, you know, those are stair shaped. I know. Yeah, I think it looks good. I think that looks good. I like it! So, how do I get you without dying? Off cam. I guess that's the way to go. Let's have a last quick look at the greenhouse and see how things are going. And then I release you to watch other stuff on YouTube. Coming! Jumping doesn't really make it faster. I started growing all of this stuff as well, you know, the standard crops, middling, looks good, getting there. Started growing the berries, we really only need the mehoberry, or mejoberry, stimberry, and narcoberry, those two for crafting, those for taming and ingredients for whatever, and then of course the kibble itself. Not much around here, these started growing, yeah, looking good, all middling. So no fruits yet, but we are getting there. There's nothing yet, okay. Yeah, that's 3 hours. So we do need to upgrade the crop plots, I do believe so. I got rid of the signs where I had all four plots seeded, which is, I think, just over here with the crops. No need to put the sign here if you see what you're harvesting, right? We do the same everywhere. Those signs, they really bug me. They block the view on the lovely textures of all those crops, so they're gonna go as soon as everything's planted. I could have put them just like here, but if you have something that grows bigger like this, not necessarily the berries, but like all of these, sour root, well, the long grass definitely grows quite big, and the citronelle as well. If you have the sign behind that, you can't really see it. This is temporary, just don't worry about it. We're gonna get rid of it too. And then you have a lovely outlook on just the crops. I mean, these crops will definitely block the view if you put a sign behind it. Actually don't need you because I know what's going to go here. Fortunately, there is no pick-upable sign. Structures Plus doesn't do that. Would be nice, you know, a sign that actually snaps. Especially for stone walls where you have the beams going through, make the sign snap in a way that the beam is not going through. Or paintings, make them snap on a wall so that you can put, I don't know, four paintings on one wall, and then you can have them, those ARK paint jobs where you need like 18 paintings, canvases stuck together to make one continuous picture. You know what I mean, right? We've done that before, the kibble sheet and stuff like that. That would be nice. That's something for Structures Plus to add, I think. Alright. Anyway, that's... Ooh. Zooming out. Yeah, I had to have a look at the wall, so I had to zoom out when I placed the gate. Here I am. Need to still dye the armor, but I think we're only going to do that once we actually find blueprints for Ascendant gear. Might even go back to Chitin if Ascendant gear is good enough, because that just looks better. Or maybe leather. You never know. That's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more, leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. Don't. No, really, don't. That's important. Enjoy yourselves. See you soon. Bye-bye.